For this video, I wish to shout out for a viewer who asked this question and which made me realize that some more people might need help on this topic. Thank you so much, Arka Prabha. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. Thank you so much for asking this question. Your little comment will now be a reason for the awareness of many. Thank you so much. Career breaks are still a taboo in Indian industry. Though all of us admit that we all are humans, not robots, so life do happen sometime in a different way than we plan for it. Given a choice, none of the professionals would want to have a career gap, isn't it? But still, let's admit it, we all have faced those nasty questions, those tough looks for taking a break in our career. As if we forgot everything that we learned over a period of time and became Ghazni in that career break. I too faced all those questions, especially post my maternity break. But here I want to tell you something. A lot of it depends on the perception of the person who's taking your interview. Mostly, it's not about companies. Most of the time, it depends on the hiring manager and the people involved in the interview, basically interview panel. So if you feel you have done really well technically in any interview and chances are that you got rejected because of your career gap, then you might have spoken about a reason of gap that gave a sense of uncertainty or liability to the interviewer, which made him feel that it can affect the past uncertainty or whatever the gap reason was, will affect your productivity or your stay with the company in near future. So here are few things that I want to share with you all so that you can answer those questions mindfully. So stay tuned.
Welcome to Corporate Diary.
Welcome back, guys. So first we will start with gap questions and answers for freshers. Later half of the video we will address gap reasons for experienced professionals. So the first thing is how you as a fresher see your career gap. If you are not confident enough in your skills and you feel your career gap will earn you some negative score in an interview, then hear this. As long as you are good in what you are claiming to be good at, example whatever you have written in your resume, if you are thorough with all that, plus you are not using your career gap as an excuse to not answer any question, then the career gap hardly matters in the end result of a fresher's interview. I've seen a lot of freshers with a gap. During the interview, if they are not sure of any answer, they just blame it on their career gap. They would be like, it's been so and so much time, so I am now not aware of whatever that technology is, or I don't remember whatever the answer of that question is. Please stop doing that. Think as if that career gap never happened, that never existed. Do you think a fresher who's recently passed out and who is not sure of any answer will say this thing? There can be a lot of questions for which you don't know the answer, but there is absolutely no reason to blame your career gap on that. That gives a enhanced sense to the interviewer that there is a lot that you have missed out during this period. So please stop doing that and be confident in your skills. Whatever you claim to know, whatever you have written in your resume, be thorough with that. Go with a detailed preparation. For example, say there are two freshers, one passed out in 2019 and another in 2020, and they appear for an interview. They go through the aptitude test and then further interview, and their scores vary by a very little difference, like 0.5 difference. Who passed out in 2019 achieved 20.5, and the one who passed out in 2020 achieved 20 score. So what do you think, who will be given preference? The one who passed out in 2020? No, obviously not. The one who passed out in 2019. So guys, it's purely basis your technical skills. Don't get stuck into this mindset of career gap, career gap, career gap. It hardly matters once you are there in an interview. It doesn't matter much. All that matters from that point is your performance in an interview. As a HR and hiring manager myself, there are a lot of career gap reasons that we have accepted, we have welcomed wholeheartedly in variety of the companies that I work for. And here is the list. Gap due to preparation of exams, joint family business but later realize this is not what you intend to do. Gap due to health problems, that can be self or any family members. Was looking for a job but didn't get any job. If you are mentioning this reason, make sure that you point out all the stuff that you have been up to during this time. That can be participating in any hackathons or any technical events, you did any certification, any online course, or anything which is related to your career. Make sure you mention that, because that portrays the image that you are very serious about your career. Just because you didn't get any job, you didn't sit back and regret over it. You did something, you took steps to keep your skill set rich. That's a very positive image. So please make sure that you mention anything and everything which is related to your career, which you did in the time when you were not on a job or when you're hunting for a job. Next reason is got campus placement, but the company kept pushing the date of joining further and finally revoked the offer. Yes, that also happens. And the last reason on the list is gap because of marriage. This I've particularly seen with female candidates, but it's accepted for both the genders. So for freshers, the takeaway is you can be as honest as possible during your interviews while you are describing your career gap, because the person on the other side of the table really want to know what you have been up to. And all they expect from you as a freshers is basic clarity of fundamentals, your attitude towards learning and growing, plus your commitment that once hired, you should be able to stay with company for a very long time. Because the trainings and the way they groom you, the time and effort they put on a freshers cost them a lot as an employer. So if you can project these three, then you are in. So don't stress out over a career gap. Be sure and confident on your skill set and what value you can bring to the company, and rest all should fall in place. So now let's move towards the career gap reasons and answers for experienced professionals. So for them, there are two kind of gaps. First one is that you are employed currently, but you had gaps in past. So your next company might want to check on those past gaps. So second is that you're currently not employed. You're living that gap and you have applied for several positions. So the interviewer would want to check your reason for your current unemployability. So in the first situation, there isn't much to be worried about, because all the employers, mostly all of them, hire you with a more interest in your latest held profile. They are more interested in knowing about that, what you are doing in your currently held or the latest held position. So make sure that you define your KRAs really well in your resume as well, or during the interview conversation you bring them up in so much depth that the interviewer feel it's absolutely unnecessary to discuss about the gap, because the value they can see in your current KRA, your current roles and responsibility, is so rich that it doesn't matter what you did in your past. So for the second situation, where you are currently unemployed, it's very important to project yourself right. And for that, let's understand why interviewers ask this question related to gap. Ideally, the career gap question shouldn't be asked unless the candidate himself or herself bring the topic inside the conversation. But almost all interviewers ask this question because in their mind, in their perception, they are checking two things. One is your employability and second is your stability. If you understand this logic well, you'll be yourself able to distinguish between a good answer and a not so good answer for a career gap reason. Try to understand this. The gap reason is a past thing. Whatever held you back from not working in this time is a past thing. The interviewer is not worried about your past. They have nothing to do with your past. All they are concerned is that if that past reason has a possibility of reoccurrence in near future, which can make you less productive or which can make you unstable, your stay with the company is not seen well, then that is something that makes the interviewer think whether to hire you or not. For example, let's say you mentioned the reason for your career gap is that your mother wasn't keeping well and you had to stay back home to take care of her as there was no other option, which is a genuine reason. You exaggerated the situation to justify your gap. Now that might give a perception or a picture to the interviewer that you will not be able to focus on your job because it's demanding in nature or it involves a lot of travel and you have heavy responsibilities back at home. though it's not ethical, he's no one to judge you or judge your performance that way, because if you are out there in the market to search for a job, that means you already have plans back at home or to manage your life. But still, people judge you, interviewers judge you on that grounds as well. That's the harsh reality, and it is the biggest setback for comeback moms after maternity. So anyways, in this video I'm not addressing the maternity context because it's a big topic in itself to discuss. So here I'm more talking about the other reasons other from maternity. So for experienced professionals, from my opinion, the best answer ensure two things. One, it should be more inclined towards reality. You shouldn't fake the reason at all. One is, it should be inclined towards the reality. Be as real as you can. Second, it should ensure, your answer should ensure that the reason of the gap is not existing anymore. It shouldn't give hints to the interviewer that it has any possibility of reoccurrence. For example, the same situation, you mentioned your mother wasn't well. Don't exaggerate the situation, just mention that, people will understand. And then plus mention that you have now people to support you, your sibling shifted nearby or in the same home, or maybe now you got married, your partner is there to look after her. So things like that. Hope you understand. Be as real as you can, plus ensure that the reason behind your gap is not existing anymore. There are no chance that the same situation can reoccur or can impact in any way you or your productivity in your future. Also, as I said, I don't recommend faking any random reason. Please don't do that whatsoever. I'll explain you with the help of an example. So this happened in one of the stints in the companies I was working for. We hired a guy. So during the interview, he mentioned that his mom wasn't keeping well. So he took a career break, almost like 1.5 years, to take care of her. And when the things eventually got better, so he wanted to resume work. So he was coming back after a career break. So he was technically really sound. We hired him, and then he wanted to join post 2 months for some reason. I don't really remember what the reason was. And I think 2 months is a long time to forget something which has been faked up, which is not real. So he joined us after 2 months, and in his first week of joining, he was talking to a senior leader. So in that casual conversation, they both were talking something about family. So this guy, he almost forgot what reason he mentioned in the interview, and he went ahead and said, I really struggled growing up because I lost my mother when I was really young, and my father had to travel city so many times in a week, so it was really hard for me, and I had to really take care of myself and the house from a very early stage. So he was on and on into his conversation, didn't realize that what he's talking. So the senior leader didn't say him anything. He just finished the conversation, and after that he came back to the HR team, and there he mentioned everything what has happened, and he wanted to recheck what his reason of gap was. So we pulled out the documents, and it was very much documented there whatever he has mentioned the gap reason is. And the senior leader was really surprised to see that, because he thought he's a very positive and honest kind of person, though he might be. He just have faked the reason because of some random logic that he think is, but still it gives a very negative image to the other person. So it brings me to a very important point, guys, that I want to mention here. In an interview, you might meet 3 to 4 people, or 5 or 6 or 7 people, but your feedback of the interview floats to the entire team. So don't think if you have not met a person during an interview, then he don't know the whole story. That's not the case. The whole team you are joining, and maybe more people who are related to the job role that you will be joining, the stakeholders associated with that role will know your feedback. They usually know about you. Maybe not the minute details, but the overall story will flow to so many people. So don't do that mistake. So the last point that I wish to add here is, if you have reached the interview stage, then the career gap does not matter as much as it did in resume screening. If you have reached the interview stage, don't go there with the baggage of your career gap. Be confident in your skills and perform your best technically, because that's what all matters. And let the interviewer feel that your technical skills are so profound that your gap is such a small thing in comparison to your skills. Your confidence in your own abilities will take you far more than anything else. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope I added some value to your perception. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see you in my next video. Stay safe and happy. Take care. Bye.